The Browns lose again.
Yes.
Well, first they tied. With the Steelers early in the season. But they lose again, basically, to the Steelers and don't look good in doing so. You bring in this new stud quarterback. Everyone loves them. Ooh. Jerseys are being sold. But they still look like 90% of the old Browns. Right. They're not losing everything. They're just not winning much.
Right.
I mean, you know, you're Ohio State guy.
It's very hard to come back from 1-31 as a head coach. Mm-hmm. You know, there's so much negativity surrounding it going in that anything less than, you know, maybe 8-8, 9-7, you just felt like it was just, you're just on your last leg. Like, I used to work at I used to sell insurance, right? Car insurance. And I was very good at it, but I would always come back late from lunch because I hated the job. So, so they give you like a little point system. So you have like, you know, X amount of times and you're out of here, right? When you're at 9, and you got to come back at lunch at 11:30, and it's 11:29, and you're still in the car. You know, you already know you're at your limit. And I think, you know, for the Browns and Hugh Jackson and Todd Haley, from the beginning, they had very, very, very margin of error to lose. And once it started going left, and it was like all that. And if you remember on Hard Knocks, Haley and Jackson was kind of button heads. So I think that's Hugh Jackson's fault. You got to bring in somebody when you won at 31 that's lock and key with you. Not someone that's thinking in the back of his mind, hey, if he gets fired, I can get the job.
So you think that maybe that's not that it was motivation, but just that there needs to be a fluidity with the coaching.
Yes.
With the coach across the board to make sure. Because you know, there's some guys, maybe they need someone that pushes back a little bit and allows to be that. But in this situation, as you mentioned, there's no room for error when it comes to that. Sometimes that'll cause divisions within the team.
Yeah, when you don't have the security, you need everybody behind. Because then if you don't have the security, you know what people do? Like, not to keep using a relationship situation, but if you keep messing up with your girl, and your girl goes tell her friends all the time, and the friends go tell some other guys, you know what the other guys gonna be like? Hey, I saw him at the club. I mean, I don't know exactly what he was doing. It was a couple of girls, you know, standing by. They're going to plant seeds. And I think Hugh Jackson, I think he had people on his staff that was planting seeds. Like, hey, I think we could be a really good team. I really think we could do, you know, this for Baker Mayfield. But we need to, you know, get Hugh out of there.
Will Hugh get another job somewhere else, another chance?
Maybe not as a head coach. Mm-hmm. I mean, he seems like a really, you know, sometimes I think we get confused the coaching and the person. He seems like a really nice guy. Him and Ty Lue, you know, they seem like really nice people.
We have some Ohio,
you know, it's just, you know, the coaching aspect of the head coaching. Some people are just better as assistants and playing the backup. You got to learn it like, are you Scottie Pippen or are you Michael Jordan? Some people are just better at Scottie Pippen and nothing wrong with that. Hall of Fame career, right? But everybody can't be Michael Jordan. And I don't think Hugh's a Michael Jordan type of coach.
He's from the Belichick coaching tree? Which one of the guys are? There's so many from the Belichick coaching tree. Sometimes I get surprised as who came out. It wasn't necessarily Hugh. It was.
There's a lot from the Bell, but they're not very good.
Yeah.
You won't find too many. That's why you can't remember any, because none of them are that good.
Yeah. It's
Always tells me that maybe a little more Brady than Belichick.
Yeah, I mean, the Parcells coaching tree is known. You know, that's what it did.
Yeah, so, you know, sometimes it's the player, not the coach, but, you know, just like a good player can get subpar players more money, same thing with a successful coach.
Moves like this in the middle of the season, I feel like, though, it pacifies fans. Because really, what's going to happen? Another interim coach comes in.
Yeah.
Are the players suddenly going to figure out what they're doing wrong?
Right.
They're going to be put in different positions. It's still the same system. Mm-hmm. It's not like Hugh Jackson leaves and therefore the system has changed. It takes a while to implement these kind of systems. So next year, we're looking for that. But who knows? Maybe there's a jolt to the system. They win one game. People lose their mind. And go, oh, we won a game.
Sometimes that happens and it messes them up because, like you said, they just happy to get some of the toxic parts out. Mm-hmm. And then they go on a little 3-4 game winning streak. And next thing you know, you hire the interim guy full term. But then after the adrenaline high of having just a new coach around goes away, then you realize, hey, this guy's an interim for a reason.
That happens way more than you would think. Happened at USC with my Trojans.
See, there you go. That's another example.
People calling for his head. I'm not ready for it yet as far as my Trojans. We're just a little impatient as fans in LA. But people also calling for for Dave Roberts' head from the Dodgers because they lost the second World Series. But you know what? I'm not calling for that either. He made mistakes, but it's not over yet. We went to 2 straight World Series. I'm just saying, I hate to keep crossing all these sports up, but Denise and I talked about it on Friday, and she found out that I'm not a Lakers fan, and she was appalled. And I was like, it's because of the way a lot of times fans approach things. LA fans get a bad rep for leaving games early. I think that's a bad rep. I've been to games in Baltimore. I've been to games in D.C. I've been to games in New York. And you know what people do? They leave games early when it's over.
Yeah, when it's over.
That's what fans do. That's not an L.A. thing. But what L.A. fans do is they expect things to happen every year for them. If it doesn't happen right away, it's like, fire that guy. I was like, calm down.
Yeah.
Like, you know, think about, you watch two World Series teams go back-to-back to the World Series. Yes, they lost. Yes, they're disappointed. Yes, it's annoying. But you could be done with your season early August and be like, yeah, we're last in the division. It sucks.
I often wonder what's worse. And I used to talk about this with LeBron when he loses the finals all the time. Is it better to lose early and keep that finals record, the World Series, pristine? Or is it better to get all the way there and then lose because now you're 0-2 or you lost back-to-back finals, back-to-back World Series, and you're so close, so but it's magnet. Because if they lose in the divisional round, we're not talking about the Dodgers right now. We would have been moved on weeks ago. But now that they went all the way through, got right to the precipice, now it's like, oh, well, would they have been talking about firing Dave Robinson if he just lost?
Right.
If he had just lost to the Brewers?
Yeah.
It would have blew right past because he didn't make it to the World Series.
Because before that, when they weren't going to the World Series, it was like, oh, they're losing in the DS. They're losing in the CS. And they keep losing in these early rounds of the playoffs. But then now that it's happening, the expectation is we have to win or else this guy has to be out of here. Because the next guy.
Here's the thing. The next guy that comes in, you don't have any margin of error. You have to win the World Series. Now, that actually happened with, you know, Boston. Yeah. The guy comes in, he wins, and now he's, you know, he can have his drinks for free forever. But if you come into the Dodgers, you know, and we've seen that happen before. You know, that's what happened to Ty Lue. You know, Dave Blatt left. You got to win now, and he won. But then it's like, well, LeBron's going, we don't need you anymore.
We found out what the real winning recipe is. So, lesson learned. Have some patience, you guys. You could be the Cleveland Browns.
Yeah, that's true.
Just saying.
You know what's my favorite song? You could ring my bell. So do it, why don't you? Ring the damn bell. And download the TYT app. Available on Android and iOS.